Hi everyone, in this video we're going to do a little experiment on dry pour concrete. What we're going to do is make a small block of dry pour concrete and break it after 24 hours to see if there are any dry spot or air pocket inside. We're doing this today because I'm actually planning on adding an extra parking lot in my front lawn. If you look over here, I've actually prepared this, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to pour concrete here and form it in time by myself. So I'm actually considering dry pour concrete. And if this little experiment worked, I'll probably use that method for this project. So let me know in the comment section if you think that that is a good or bad idea. So what I'll do is I'll be using this clear container for this experiment so we can see how the water is distributed properly as it cures. This is a 6 by 6 by 3.5 inches in height. So the height is exactly the same as a 2x4 wood. So what I did here is I also cut the bottom portion of this container to simulate a real world application where it can drain properly as we apply the water to it so that it can also grab moisture from the soil or the soil can grab moisture away from it. So let me set this up and fill it up with dry concrete. So I actually have two, so I'm gonna put one here and another one right there. So if you can see, I compacted the soil a little. Okay, and I'll be putting this here, and I'll be putting another one right here. So, and I'm doing this because most of the instructions are telling us to lightly mist the top of the concrete and then wait an hour, and then lightly mist again, and then wait another hour before you start showering. My concern with that procedure is that the cement might start curing. I'm concerned about the laminate effect that, you know, there'll be like small portion of concrete and then another small portion of concrete. I just want to make sure that the whole concrete is dried at the same time. So I'm going to do the procedures that most are talking about in YouTube on this one. And then I'm going to do another one here. And what I'll do here is I'll probably put a little more mist so that it can absorb throughout, and I would like to see if it will go into damage the top. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. And by the way, while we're doing this, if you can just help my channel by clicking on the subscribe button below and make sure to like this video as well so that it can be pushed by the algorithm to more people. Okay, so next is we will flatten the area using this creed. And according to most people who've done this project, they want you to put a lot on top, okay? So when you screed it, it actually leaves the powder on the top. They said that if your cement is too low, then that's where you're going to start seeing the rocks form. But for now, I'm just going to go ahead and do it this way. Okay, so it looks like it does smooth properly. Just gonna keep going back to the places where there are rocks showing. Okay, so I guess that's good enough. Let me go smooth in the other side. Okay, so now let's go ahead and give this other one a try. Next, you wanted to put your hose into the mist setting. And according to the instruction, you want the mist lightly on the top. So what I'll do on that one right there, I'm gonna mist slightly, and on this other one I'm gonna mist a little more, okay, and see if it will damage the top when I do that. Okay, so let's go ahead and do it. So they said that once it changed the color, that should be good enough, but for this one here I'm gonna do it a little more. Okay, okay, so after you mist it for a few seconds, the color should change into a darker color. Originally, I was thinking I would mist this a little more compared to the other one, but I'm gonna switch that because the breeze is actually going in that direction. So I mist both of them right now at the same time, and then now I'm gonna go ahead and mist that one a little bit longer. Basically doing that, I just wanna see if it will absorb more water and if you'll cure it better. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll mist this another 2 minutes longer just to get more water saturated into it. And I'm covering this other one so that it doesn't get any more water. Okay, so this is the concrete that I just missed lightly. And if you look over there, the mist is really just on top right there. So I'm not really sure if this is good or bad. I'm hoping I will be able to mist all the way to the bottom. Let's go ahead and check the other one. So this is the one that I missed for about 2 minutes, and you can see half an inch wet on the other side, about 3/4 of an inch on the other part. Okay, so let me try to see if I can actually mist this all the way through, and I'll leave the other one and do it the way the internet is telling us. Okay, so I just wanted to quickly show you this. So I missed this for about 5 minutes, and you can see right now the soil around it are saturated. And let's go ahead and look inside. You can see here the water actually goes down to about maybe about 2 inches now. And if you go around, you're going to see also right here, because the ground is getting saturated, that it is now starting to pick up water from underneath. So now the water is wicking up right here, and then there are also water from the top going down. And this is another view. This is on one side. See right here, there's a lot of water here right now going up, so they're now meeting in the middle. So let me go ahead and mist it a couple more minutes, and let's see if we can see everything to be wet. And the good thing right now is, if you look on top, it looks like the top did not even get bothered. So it still looks smooth. I'm gonna continue watering this. It's gonna cause my soil to be mudded and saturated, but that's fine. What I want is for the water to go through the whole thing, okay? Okay, so I misted this thing for about 10 minutes, and you can see right now it's completely saturated around, okay? And this is the one that we just missed slightly on top. So the top is starting to harden. It's starting to dry up right here. And if you can see under, compare this color to this color, this thing is still dry right here, okay? So this is dry powder still, wet on the top. This one is wet on top all the way through the bottom. So let's wait for the first hour, and then let me go mist this thing again. And maybe this one, I'll mist it some more. Okay, so let me go ahead and do the second misting. Now this time I'm going to mist this again until the top changes into a darker color. Okay, it's good enough. Now this one here, I'm just going to mist it the same way I did earlier. I'm going to mist it a little longer. Hopefully it will soak through. You can see the water is going that way, so this one's not getting wet at all, okay? Okay, I guess that's good enough. Okay, so this is now hour number two. This is the one that I lightly missed. Let me go press it. It looks like it's strong enough to get more water in it, but I can still press my finger in it. See that? So let me go check the other one that I saturated earlier. See right here, this is still darker color compared to the other one. They both feel about the same, but I think this is a little more hardened compared to the other one. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to apply the shower settings on both of this. But since this one have already been saturated, I'm not going to put too much water in this anymore because I don't want it to get weakened. But for this one, I'm going to be applying a little more water. Hopefully it will saturate all the way through. Okay, so this is gonna be the second shower. So it looks like this thing have actually got wet already inside. After the first shower, it was able to saturate it and get most of the concrete wet. Okay, but that one is completely wet already. Okay, so this is about 24 hours after pouring it and watering it. This is the one that I saturated with mist on the first round. And if you look over here, this is the one that I misted slightly, and it have a nicer finish in it. It is actually smoother, but you see that there are some more cracks. So it's probably my fault here. Maybe I should have mist it some more so that it could go a little deeper. And if you compare that to here, this is more even, but the surface is more rough. So I guess they're both hard enough for us to remove it from the form and soft enough for us to be able to still break it. So let's go ahead and do that. So this is a side. It looks solid to me. It looks really nice. And this is the under. The under looks nice as well. So let me go get the other one. So this is the one that we slightly missed. Okay, so the side looks really nice as well. And also the bottom right here. Okay, so I'd like to do a side-by-side comparison. This is the one that is slightly missed. And this is the one that is soaked right away. And you can see they're both solid. The one that's slightly missed have a lot of imperfection. Actually, a lot of parts already came out from the top right here. So I guess when you missed it, you want to saturate it enough, but not too much that it would damage the top surface. This one right here, actually, when I first saturated, it was fine. But then on the second hour, when I saturated again, the top started to become more rough because I feel like the water started to damage it. So I think I'm going to do another experiment, and that's going to be like saturating it enough so that it will absorb all the water. But instead of watering it every hour, like what I did with this, maybe I'll have to wait another 2 or 3 hours, because after the first hour, this one still looks wet to me, while this one have completely dry up. Basically, after the first hour, color on this one turned light already, while this one, after 1 hour, it's still dark. So I should have waited a little longer before I give it another round of watering. So if you look right here on the side, it looks really nice and solid. Same thing with this one. Nice and solid. So what I'll do is I'm gonna see if I can still cut this since it's still soft. Hopefully my saw could still cut through it. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so this is cut in half. It does look pretty solid to me. This one, I believe it's just because of the saw that it removes the rocks from there. But it does look pretty solid to me. It still looks like a clay because it's still drying up. And you can see right now, it's smooth. Same thing with this one right here. This one here still like, looks like it's still drying up. So you can see that there are portion of it that still need to set. So this will, I believe this will work. You just have to make sure that you keep wetting the concrete after it sets so that it can fully cure, okay? So let me go cut the other one. So this is the one that's misted lightly at the beginning. And it looks to me like all the part of the concrete are hydrated properly. But you can see right here, because this took like 8 watering compared to the other one. This one is still curing right here. But they do both look solid. And again, this is the one that's saturated right from the beginning. This is the one that's lightly misted. You can see they kind of like look the same. So what I'll do is I'm just gonna let this cure for the next 7 days, and then I'll do another video on this just to show you how they both look like. So what do you think? Do you think this will be good enough for a driveway? Let me know in the comment section. And also, I hope that you found this video helpful to you. Please help my channel by clicking the like and the subscribe button. And thank you for watching.